This video will give a conceptual overview to how a message-oriented middleware can be used in an application. So it will not be very detailed and there will not be any code examples, but instead I'll try to sketch an outline of how the chat application could be implemented using a message-oriented middleware for communication. So here is a client node of the chat application, and as usual there will be the view and controller layers. Remember, this dashed line means dependency, any kind of dependency. Now, when using the message-oriented middleware, there will also be a net layer, because remember that, as opposed to object-oriented middleware, a message-oriented middleware is not completely transparent to the application code. It will be obvious, the application code, that the network call is being made. Then we have the chat application server, where there will also be a net layer. And as in all chat applications, a controller and a model. And now there is also a third node, namely the message queue. First, let's consider the case that one client wants to send a message, and this message shall be broadcasted to all other clients. Here the message queue's publish-subscribe messaging domain will be used. In this messaging domain, a topic is defined, which is like a logical identifier. And a client, the client one on this image, can publish a message to a certain topic, and clients can also, clients two and three in this image, ask the message queue for subscription to a particular topic. So when the message is published by client 1 to the topic, the message will be delivered by the message queue to all clients 2 and 3 here that subscribes to this particular topic. In the chat application, the message queue would have a topic. Let's call it chat MSG. Green here means application-specific things in the messaging queue. Black is the message queue as such, and the blue things are the clients and the server. Sometime, maybe during startup, all clients have registered themselves to subscribe to the chat MSG topic. And also the server during startup has subscribed to the chat MSG topic. Actually, there's something missing in this image, and that is the message queue client. So the message queue client is a product provided by the message queue vendor that handles the actual communication between a node using the message queue and the message queue itself. So one can say it's like a driver for the message queue, and it must reside on all nodes that communicates with the message queue, that is, the server and all clients in the chat program. So then let's draw the subscribe call from the client and the server. When it's time to register subscription, the startup code makes a call to the net package, which handles all interaction with the message queue client. So in the net package, we instruct the message queue client to subscribe to the topic, and the message queue client will perform the network call and actually register this subscription. And this same thing happens on all clients and also on the server. Then let's see what happens when a client sends a message to all other clients. So the view will have instructed the controller to perform the send operation. The view will forward that call to the net package, and the net package will instruct the message queue client to actually publish the message. The message queue client then will perform the publishing of the message to the queue, and when the message is published to this topic, it will be delivered to all the subscribers, which are all clients and the server. So the message is delivered to the client, and not much room now. Okay, I'll draw it like this. Of course, the message goes through the network to avoid too many crossing lines. I'll draw it like this. So the message is delivered to the message queue client on all the subscribing nodes, and also to the server's message queue client, which informs our code in the net package. We have probably registered a listener in the net package. So then on the client, the message will appear in the view. Perhaps there is an observer registered. In that way, the observer can be directly informed. Or perhaps we make an ordinary up call to the controller, which then calls the view. Okay, and on the server, there is a call to the controller, which then will inform the model that this message was now delivered. And on the model, as in previous chat programs, there will be an object which keeps the entire conversation, for example in an array of strings. So this newly delivered message will arrive at the object in the model that keeps the entire conversation. Okay, so this is what happened when a client sent the message. So important here is to note that it's the message queue that is the actual server that broadcasts the message, and what is called server, that is the server in our application here, also acts as a client and just receives notification about the fact that the message was delivered and stores it in the model. So one can see a clear advantage with such a solution, namely that the message queue node at the bottom is created for the sole purpose of being a server in such a messaging application. It has all the code to deliver messages, no need to write such code in our own server. But also the message queue already has functionality to persist messages, to handle transactions and security and whatever. So of course the message queue is better at this task than our own server. No need to rewrite the code in our own server. Okay, but now let's leave this process of publishing a message and instead have a look at what happens when a new client joins the chat. What we want to achieve is that the new client shall receive the entire conversation up to this point, and of course also shall receive future messages. So I have erased the sending of a message from one client to all other clients to make room for this new situation, but we still have the model of the server here where all existing messages are kept. So to understand how this shall be handled, we have to understand another messaging domain, which is point-to-point messaging, or queues. In queue-based communication, one client sends to one other client, not one client to all clients, as in the pub-sub messaging domain using topics. So here in this image, client 1 wants to send a message to client 2, and by doing that, the client sends the message to a particular destination, which is identified by the queue, and the client 2 can then receive or consume the message by asking the queue for messages. Note that client 1 and client 2 are decoupled. They only identify the queue. They do not identify each other. Client 1 sends to the queue, and client 2 receives from the queue. It is not necessarily as depicted here that the client 2, that wants to receive the message has to make an explicit call and poll the queue for existing messages. It can also be that the client 2 registers a listener that is notified when a message arrives to the queue. Right, so now let's assume that the blue client to the left has just started and wants to receive the entire conversation up to this point to show on the user interface. So the client will make an RPC call using the message queue. Remember, RPC meant remote procedure call. We will use the message queue to mimic an RPC call where the client sends a request to the server processes the request and sends back an answer to the client. And the processing of the request in this case is just to return the entire conversation. Okay, so now we need a queue on the message queue server. Let's call it entire conversation. On the client side, we somehow arrive in the controller where a request is made to the net package to receive the entire conversation. Our code in the net package, which provides the interface to the message queue client, we'll call the message queue client and we'll ask it to send to the entire conversation queue. EC means entire conversation. Okay, the message client will send to the message queue this request that will arrive in the entire conversation queue and from there be delivered to the server, because the server either has issued a blocking request to the entire conversation queue and is waiting for a message to arrive, or has registered a listener and will be notified when the message arrives. So anyway, the server will know that a message arrived to the entire conversation queue. The message queue client on the server will inform our server code that this message arrived. It will be passed through the controller to the model, where the conversation will be returned the same way. And when it is returned, the net layer will ask the server's message queue client to send the message back to the client. And the message queue client will send the message back. And the message will be returned to the client that asked for the conversation. Because the client also must have registered a listener for this queue. The return conversation will somehow be displayed on the user interface by a registered observer or an upcall via the controller or something, but this thing here will eventually arrive at the screen. Here is the screen. This is the general idea about how to retrieve the entire conversation. Then there are some design topics which is really outside of this course, since we don't cover message queues in detail. And that is, we are to use different queues for each client, or different queues for sending messages from client to server, the response from server to client, and things like that. But that will not be considered here. It's sufficient to understand that a point-to-point messaging using a queue can be used to retrieve the entire conversation from the server. Let me also mention a few words on event-driven architectures. So, an event-driven architecture means that we do not really have any model on the server side, but instead we just store events that happen. And in the chat application, events are of course published entries in the chat conversation. Also, clients joining and leaving are events, but they in a sense also result in messages. Client X joined, client Y left, and so on. Okay, so what is the difference between a model and an event-driven architecture storing events? So the difference is that an MVC architecture using a model stores a kind of summary of all events in the model. It does not store individual events. That is not so obvious here, because the summary of the model, which is the entire conversation, is just a series of event published messages. But say instead that we had a server that calculated the sum of numbers. Say that we pass to the server the number 2. Now the server's model would contain the state 2. Then we pass 3 to the server and the model would contain 5. We pass 7 and the model would contain 12, and so on. So now we see that the model on the server contains a state based on everything that has happened. But there is no way from the number 2 or the number 5 or the number 12 to tell which numbers have been added. So that is a classical model-based architecture. If we instead had an event-based architecture, then if the number 2 was sent to the server to begin with, the server would store the number 2, then the number 3 was sent, and then the server would add the 3 to its list of events. So now it would have the events 2, 3, and then 7, and now it would have the list 2, 3, 7. So it would keep just the events that happened, not the total state. If at this point here a client was interested in the sum, the client would send the request for the sum and the server would then perform the calculation 2 plus 3 plus 7 and return 12. Or the server could return 237 and the client would have to compute 2 plus 3 plus 7 and get the result 12. Okay, so this is an event-driven architecture. And we can see that such an architecture would be a very good fit for this application, because we're almost there. There's really no need to maintain the model, because all it contains is this list. So instead, the controller could directly call a storage, a database or a file or something, and just save the conversation as it is. So this is a quite frequently used architecture. An event occurs and the server just stores the information that this event occurred. And all calculations are performed in the client. So now the client has the model. The layer where calculations are performed and where it keeps the state of the entire application. This is quite useful architecture when you have a huge amount of clients like mobile phones or web application. Mobile phones would maybe use RESTful web services to access the server, and web-based applications would maybe use WebSockets. And so with an event-driven architecture, we don't need the server to keep track of the state of thousands or millions of clients. Okay, but do we need the server at all? If the only purpose of the server now is to store messages in the database and read messages from the database, then if we could have the message queue access the database instead of the server, then in fact we would not need the server at all, and that would of course be a great simplification. So here there are some products that directly come to mind, for example Apache Kafka, which is like a pub-sub message queue that also stores messages persistently. So that might be a good fit here. Another product that comes to mind is the Caching WebSocket Gateway, that is constructed to keep many, maybe tens of thousands of open WebSocket connections. Okay, so I have not given an implementable solution. I've just tried to sketch an outline of how the chat application could be implemented using a message-oriented middleware. And as you see, there are many interesting and powerful solutions that one could consider here. So there are no mandatory parts on message-oriented middleware in the course. So actually, if you want to make life easy, then you don't have to bother anymore about this, for this course at least. But if you are interested in learning more about message-oriented middleware, it's a good alternative for the project to get the bonus points for using a communication paradigm that was not covered in the homework. So that way you can learn message-oriented middleware and also get something out of it in terms of your grade for this course.